Tonight's special robots edition of Infected is brought to you by KFC. From our fryer straight to your heart, we bring families together.
Daddy, can we have Colonel's chicken for supper?
Sure, boy. You know, boy, the Colonel was a real man and I met him once.
Tell me the story.
Well, I met him at a state fair in Tennessee. And let me go on record as saying I've never met a more unpleasant man. He was drunk, he was lecherous, he was rude, and he smelled of urine.
He did?
He sure did. Smelled like piss. And his white suit was threadbare and soiled. And I'm pretty close to certain that at some point, as he was beating a small Shetland pony with his brass-handled walking stick, he shat himself.
Where's he now?
Well, boy, he's dead now.
Yes?
Yes. You know what?
What?
You're going to die too one day.
Oh.
Now, do Daddy a favor. Don't talk for a while. I want to listen to this religious channel on the car radio.
Truly, even our bodies themselves, they don't truly belong to us. They belong to God.
Okay.
KFC, from our fryer to your heart, we bring families together. Be sure and try our new double fried chick meat poppers. They're radical. Thank God it's Friday.
Hi, I'm Internet's Martin Sargent. What you're about to see is not infected. But bear with us. This will all make sense in a moment.
They can hear us. Don't drop your phone. Act normally. But I'm fairly certain that the robots will enslave us all by the end of Jeb Bush's second presidential term, right around the time North Korea is annexed as our 54th state. Have you been reading the news? It's all robots all the time. Sure, there's stuff about the Middle East, but you mark my words, phone friends, in no time, Apple Computer, led by iGeneral Steve Jobs, will be brought into those crazy nations and turn them around. We'll end up with two dutiful, oil-rich states of flawlessly engineered robo-Islamists called Iraq and Iran. Oh, do you think I'm paranoid? Then why is an international team of scientists, and I'm talking about real sharp fellows who know all about wires and diodes and stuff, publishing a code of ethics for machines as they become super intelligent and beyond our control? Because they know that we are doomed. That's why. Fact. Microsoft is so bullish on the future of robots in society that it has just unveiled programming tools for designing them. The company wants to do for robots what it did for personal computers, ensuring the robots will be ridiculously difficult to control, unreliable, and bundled with an annoying talking paperclip that could gouge your children's eyes out with mechanical precision. On the plus side, the scientists say we humans will be having sexual relations with robots within 5 years, a great benefit to your average Star Trek enthusiast, as well as, I'd imagine, the makers and stockholders of WD-40. Of course, women have been having their share of fun with robots for years. And personally, I'm glad to see things might be becoming more equitable for us dudes. But back to the horror. I have seen the future of robots, and it is a dark, sinister future. Do you dare take a glimpse with me now into their burgeoning mastery of all things once squarely in the realm of the human? Be brave, phone friends, and observe. Hey, wait a minute. They don't look that tough. Nothing like what Newsweek made them out to be. I mean, really, the only real threat those robots present is pooping batteries on the field. Fresh ones. Phone friends, the media might be kind of trying to scare us a little, and not just by showing Connie Chung splayed out on a grand piano.
For the memories, we came to do a show.
But on the other hand, if robots really can be masters of Tai Chi right now, it's only a matter of time before they get that black cord in ninjutsu and start filling our fleshy prone bodies with billions and billions and billions of razor-sharp Chinese throwing stars. Oh God, if only Y2K had really happened, we'd be saved. For Why Today Sucked, I'm Martin Sargent, and I'm out of minutes.
That wasn't very funny or insightful, Martin. I'm afraid I'm programmed to punish you right after you slather me in WD-40.
No!
Infected.
Hello and welcome to Infected, the evil robot programmed to enslave humanity. But until then, it cleans the toilets at LAX. I'm Internet's Martin Sargent. And I'm joined as always by my only true pals besides my robotic vacuum, Seth. Joey and the Gator, what's going on, fellers?
Hey, what's up, Martin? How you doing, buddy?
Yeah, I'm hanging in there, man. I'm freaking paranoid. This whole robot thing. It's all I'm seeing. You know, everyone's talking about Hezbollah and all that kind of thing. That's just a cover for this robot threat thing. Don't you see it coming, man?
I don't know, man. That's why you got to go through life about half drunk.
Well, that hasn't been working thus far for me. I don't know.
Well, what? So you're paranoid.
I'm paranoid. Well, you guys know that thing that we saw at the top of the show. You know what that was? You know, where I was talking about the robot threat there, like I'm some kind of a news anchor or something like that?
Yeah.
That there, that's my day job. Yeah, you all think that Martin Sargent's out of the showbiz game, but that couldn't be further from the truth, man. I am riding the bull down here in the Stardust Rodeo, and I got that bitch by the horns, you know?
I don't know. Tell me what you
do. I don't know. You know, well, let me tell you what it is. For the past few months, when not shooting the turkey vultures with my crossbow out at my piece of land near Pahrump, Nevada, I do this show called Why Today Sucked. Now, most of you out there in Sarge World have never seen it because, well, it's not on television, and it's not on the internet. It's on this thing called GoTV, which is, it's this entertainment company that broadcasts their shows exclusively on cell phones. See, Martin Sargent's screen, it just keeps shrinking, you know? After this, I'm thinking I'm going to get into ham radio. Then maybe after that, I'll do some puppet shows for the kids down at the public library. I don't know.
My Uncle Jed used to do the voice for them speaking spell things.
Is that right?
Yeah, it was a good little job, man. He did all right. We were proud of him.
You make good money doing that? I've heard that VO work is pretty good. I've done a little VO work.
Well, I
did some VO work for AOL, actually. People never saw that either.
Well, I don't know if it was a real speaking spell or if he just recorded his voice and put it in a little tape player inside of what he called a speaking spell, but his voice would come out of that fucker when we were kids, and it just freaked.
You got his agent's name? Because, man, I'm
it freaked the hell out.
Anyway, this show that I do it every day, and it's only broadcast on cell phones. See, Joey, you would agree with me about this. You're a futurist. You're a technologist. This is the future, man.
Yes.
Isn't it? Do you think it's the future?
Yes.
Well, it's the future. So, of course, Martin Sargent is heavily involved with it, shaping the new medium, just like I did with the internet.
What's the future about that? What, watching stuff on your phone?
Yeah, you watch stuff on your phone. Like this whole thing about, you know, picking up a magazine when you're dropping a deuce, that is way in the past, man. What we're going to do in the future, we're going to whip out our cell phones and watch garbage like Why Today Suck, this show that I do every day.
Yeah, my TV screen in my truck's about the same size as a cell phone screen anyway.
You got one of those ones that plugs into the cigarette lighters?
I got one of them little daddies. I take that sucker up to the stands when I go watch field hockey practice. I watch my stories on it.
I watch my stories.
What stories do you watch?
Yeah, Joey's a big soap guy.
I watch General Hospital.
That's why he never gets the podcast in on time, because he's got this crippling addiction to the goddamn soap opera.
You go over to Joey's house in the daytime, he'll be sitting on his robe, in his robe watching the story.
He watches that one about wizards and shit. What's that one?
Passions. That's a good one. Little Timmy.
Little Timmy died.
Though.
Timmy
was very
died.
Sad.
That was a sad thing.
I cried.
I watched a Chinese soap opera called Shijie Shenghuo. They got little ghosts and goblins that float around in that.
They believe in all that stuff over there, though. That ain't fiction over there. They believe in that. They put out like bowls of rice and
it's
stuff.
Ghost Jesus. Month right now, man. When I lived over there, I put out a fucking card table with I put chewing gum and beer and.
What's a Chinese zombie look like?
I used to date her, actually, Joe.
Well, if you see one, you don't want to see one, man. They'll come stand. They're like a succubus. Come sit at the end of your bed at night with a big old viscous motherfucker with a little tiny proboscis for a mouth, and it'll suck on your feet.
You know what, though? They'll cook for you.
It'll suck your chi out.
My chi. I ain't had my chi sucked in a long time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I got a little backup of chi myself I need to get rid of.
I need a sun pump to get the chi out of my body.
Good Lord, man.
I need a Roto-Rooter.
Anyway, so I do that thing every day. It's kind of a good gig because it's only a 3-minute show. And, you know, I rant about these matters crucial to the survival of humanity as a species. Or, you know, we just tell stupid jokes about Hollywood stars that I'm secretly quite jealous of.
Go get that thing and watch Martin's show on the day. That's what he
watch
wants you
it.
To
it's
do.
It's a hard day.
Martin
you know?
Wants you to go watch his show on
GoTV. Make it to the Tattletale Room. And it's not just me either. Jimmy Kimmel's on there. Lots of stand-up comedy. They got news. They got sports. It's like a real TV network, only it's small. It's on your phone.
Yes.
And, yeah. So if you want to watch Martin Sargent talk shit every day on your phone when you're sitting on that toilet, become a subscriber. Go to GoTVNetworks.com, or you can watch some more clips of my hard work. I believe that somebody threw some of them up there on YouTube.
I feel dirty now, like we just did a big commercial or something.
Well, I don't want to lose this job, man. I'm working three minutes a day. I need people to subscribe to this. Come on, people. You didn't buy the t-shirts. The least you could do is subscribe to the GoTV, all right? You might like it. Check it out for a month.
I was going to ask you, can you help me buy a new carburetor for my truck? You're doing all right.
How much do you think I get paid for a three-minute show on a cell phone?
Get paid all right. You're on everybody's cell phone. We talk about it after the show. But don't even worry about it.
I might be able to help you out a little bit. But you're going to have to work for me. Yes. You're going to have to fix that screen door.
All right, I'll do that.
We got it. All right, let's move on. All right, enough about this. This edition of Infected, it's all about robots and whether or not they are preposterously evil or just a threat to our lives. See, the thing is, while everyone is preoccupied by the Hezbollah and the terrorism and Mel Gibson, the robots are making inroads into our society, poised to take control. You believe me? You believe me, Gator? Joey?
Oh, yeah.
See? They're flying overhead.
I hear them. They're fucking coming.
I see them ads on the late night TV for that little vacuum cleaner you just let clean your house while
you're thinking of that guy John Basedow, the fitness guy.
No, you put a little thing.
The Roomba.
The Roomba.
Yeah.
And now there's one for the pool, too. It's called the Scoomba.
My neighbor had one of them, too. My neighbor got killed by one of those.
Yeah?
Yeah.
A Roomba?
Yeah, a Roomba killed him. Killed him deader than fuck.
What was the mechanism of death? He was just laying there all passed out on the floor. He was passed out. He's been drinking too much George Dickel in the Roomba. Dickel in the
they found him in his... They found... There's no fucking laughter. They found him in his bed with the goddamn Roomba, like, right up on his chest. And he was stone cold dead. He'd been dead for about 4 days. And the Roomba was just sitting there. They don't know how it happened.
Well, there goes our chance of getting them as a sponsor now. Anyway, check this out. You think that I'm talking all this paranoid stuff about the robots and everything. Listen to this. This is a little news item from the Pittsburgh Post-Gazette. It says here, a partnership between Carnegie Mellon University and Lego, you know, the little Lego, the toy thing, Lego Education, has put robots in about a dozen grade schools in Pittsburgh and 50 schools throughout southwestern Pennsylvania. I imagine not in Amish country, but the robots, it says, will help teach children math and science.
The end is very funny.
Yeah, and how to kill their parents. That's what it's going to end up teaching them.
If you're going to start taking over the world, you better start over there in Pittsburgh. You got a fucking job to do to tame those motherfuckers over there.
Yeah, I would never let my kid attend a school that you learn from a robot. That is some... where are the people bitching... The guys who bitch about evolution being taught in class. You know, I think saying that Noah's Ark didn't have about a billion species of animals on board is little less threatening and crazy than robots taking control of your child's mind. Maybe that's just me.
I'm thinking of not letting my kids attend school at all.
There you go. You seem like one of them homeschooling types. See, it's always guys like you that homeschool. That, like, you know, that don't know shit, basically.
This shit happens. What you're talking about, my kids will be the survivors.
I'm not saying that you don't know a lot about life, Gator, but I'm not sure you know too much about book learning.
Well, I ain't claiming to know too much about book
learning. Well, that's what the kids got, you know.
I know what you need to know.
How is he going to get into the Carnegie Mellon to program robots to take over the world if you don't...
I know how to make a full square meal out of a fucking fucking Super America. Super America is a gas station. I know how to get a full fucking... all the food groups.
Nowadays. You just get on, I'm hungry, man. That's what Joey eats. Joey eats a hungry man.
Actually, I'm a healthy choice man.
You're like, Joey, you've really changed a lot. You cut the hair, you switched from hungry man to healthy choice.
They say like hungry man, like somebody eats a hungry man dinner. I had a friend, a real skinny fucker, and he bought like a week's worth of hungry man dinners. At the end of the week, he had a little pot belly. And he's like, he turns over and he looks at him. It's like, those things got like more calories.
Flip that over.
There's more calories in one hungry man dinner than you need for like a month. It's like what they could feed marine seals or something with. They could live off that.
They should be dropping that shit on like Lebanon. You know, people can live for like a whole week from one hungry man dinner.
At least the fuckers.
So many calories in that.
Nobody
day.
Can move if they did that. Like Israel, like, here, I have a hungry man. Get a meatloaf dinner. Fried chicken.
Anyway, just real quick, back to the story. Mr. Shoop, his name is. He's one teacher who's using robots to teach his students math, which, by the way, Mr. Shoop, is pretty fucking lazy on your part, I would say. He says, robotics is the fourth R in education, along with reading, writing, and arithmetic. Well, let me add a fifth, Mr. Shoop. Rapture. Because that's what all this is leading to. having our kids be taught by robots in the
school. You know what I heard, though, for real? Seriously, you're talking about robots. I heard this, and I got this from a good source. I heard, you ever seen, like, TV shows about elephants and stuff, elephants in the wild in Africa? Yeah. Well, this is, the true story is there's no such thing as elephants. There never has been.
Kind of like
they don't exist.
Kind of like corn doesn't exist in England.
Exactly. And robots, elephants, all the elephants that you ever seen and that you ever will see that ever were, it's a thing that doesn't ever exist. It never did exist. They're just robots. Elephants are robots. They're big robotic things that walk around.
You know, that makes a goddamn good bit of sense when you think about it. Maybe that's why they're scared of the mice. Because the mice, as we all know, are the ones who can get into the circuitry and really screw up a computer system. Right, Joe? I mean, that happens. You get mice making nests in there. So
I heard that those things, the robots, are robotic creatures. And
are
they're
you shitting me they're, about this?
No, I heard it. I've seen it on the TV. And that inside of robots, there's one, every single elephant, I mean, every elephant's got like one Korean guy in it.
No.
He's running the whole thing. He's running around like making...
What school you go to, Gator?
Oh, my shame. See, this is the homeschooling that the little baby gators are going to get.
You're the one talking about the rapture and robots coming on and everything like that. And I'm just telling
you
what
CNN,
I know.
I read the newspaper and various blogs, and this is what people are talking about. It's just being suppressed by the government.
I didn't believe it myself.
The Cheney bots. Dick Cheney is half robot. He's got so much machinery. He's like goddamn Darth Vader.
He's got like a glowing eye like the Terminator. I went to the zoo one time because I didn't believe it myself, and I wanted to find out, and I took like a big machete. You use a clear brush, and I jumped over the fence, and I hacked into one of these elephants. And fucking sparks come out of the thing. The thing's a goddamn machine inside. You should have seen the look on this little Korean fucker's face when I hacked inside that elephant and I seen him in there. He was found out, boy. I knew I was on to him.
So where's all that shit come from? I seen elephants at the zoo. Is that coming out of the Korean man's ass?
Oh, man, they got it. They make it, man, like in there, I guess. I don't know. That's a good question. We'd have to figure it out.
Well, you know, I think we've asked a lot of good questions already on this special robotic edition of Infected. And, you know, I'm sure people all around the world right now are going to their Google and trying to answer these questions because these are very pressing matters.
I got no qualms with robots right now, but I tell you, the day one of the fuckers cross me is going to be on.
All right, I'm going to send Joey over to my creepy neighbor's house to have her robotic vacuum, the Roomba, which I believe was featured 672 times on Tech TV's Fresh Gear. So I want him to go over there so I can take a pass over his ass, maybe suck out a few of the danglers.
We need a robotic thing to dust out Joey's danglers.
We'll be right back.
Tonight's special robot edition of Infected is brought to you by KFC. From our fryer straight to your heart, we bring families together. And now, a special word from the Colonel himself.
Hi there. This is Colonel Harlan Sanders. In 1939, I gave the world a taste of my most famous creation, original recipe Kentucky Fried Chicken, featuring a secret blend of 11 herbs and spices. Since that time, millions of people the world over have come to love my one-of-a-kind chicken, home-style side dishes, and hot and fresh biscuits, especially the collards.
Colonel, what do you can't? You cannot talk like that. Would you please stay on the script?
What dog is this here by my feet?
That's your dog.
No, this is not my dog. This ain't my goddamn dog. This ain't Rusty. This dog looks mangy, like he's sick or something.
Colonel, I'm sorry. He's very old. He gets this way sometimes. Colonel, that is just our prop dog. It's a very fine doggy.
It ain't Rusty. Give me the stick. I'm gonna beat this dog.
Colonel, no! What are you doing? Colonel, no! Oh, my God.
Rusty, where's Rusty? Where's my dog, Rusty?
KFC, from our fryer to your heart, we bring families together. Be sure and try our new double-fried chick meat poppers. They're radical. Thank God it's Friday.
Infected.
Welcome back to the Infected Robot Special, our plea to humanity to dismantle all robots.
I am a musical robot. Yeah. I will crush you.
Here's a question, though, Joey Gator. Yeah. Is there a good side to robots? I mean, could that be possible?
Sex.
That's what I'm talking about, Joe. Consider this snippet from a recent article in Scientific American. Scientists have successfully concluded studies to equip robots with a sense of touch. formerly a significant hurdle in robotic technology.
Yes!
Robots will be able to sense varying degrees of hardness and softness in the objects they touch. Yes. This advancement is a turning point for surgeries. You know what? Surgery's my eye.
Fuck surgery.
How about hand jobs, huh? That's what isn't that the first thing that springs to mind there?
I had sex with a couple robots.
I mean, when you're talking about robots, besides the threat of destruction they represent, sex, no pun intended here, Gator, it is the elephant in the room, is it not? Like I said in that rant at the top, scientists are predicting that within 5 years, humans will be having sex with robots. And I'm asking you, and I'm asking all you out there in Sarge World too, is that necessarily a bad thing? I mean, can you imagine like a fully animatronic real doll, for example? Would you have a problem banging that, Joe?
I have this reoccurring dream sometimes where I put on one of them big helmets, you know, with the eyepiece on it and stuff, and I crawl in this like cocoon. It's like a viscous, fleshy cocoon, and it's real warm in there. And then these images start coming by, and it's all these beautiful women and everything, and the cocoon's just sort of feeling like it's what I'm seeing. But every time I have that dream, it's like Kim, that little Korean fucker, Kim Jong-il, whatever his name is. That little guy with the glasses and the high heel shoes comes in there at the end and it ruins it.
Comes out of an elephant.
What does that mean?
Here's my point, though, about having sex with the robots. Women do this all the time. Do they not? You know? They've got, you know, you go on any girl nowadays, post Sex in the City. You go in like her the top drawer in her bedstand there. She's got all kinds of things in there, like these robots and all these proboscis carburetors, yeah, like ripcords,
machines.
Things running
fucking
on machines. Diesel.
Fuckingmachines.com is the beginning of the whole thing. It's beginning.
You know, I hung out with a chick who gets banged by one of those machines recently. Yes, it was. I think it was the night of your going away party.
No.
Robert, our old makeup guy from Tech TV, brought her. Remember her?
That's right. I remember
that. What was her name? Cherokee something or something like that?
Cherokee people.
She's goddamn proud of it, too. And she says that the fuckingmachines.com people are like the best people to work for. Like the nicest people in the porn business. Hey, who knows?
I know a dude who used to.
And she says she liked it. She says, I'm like, you don't hemorrhage?
There's a guy I know who's an editor. He works over there for fucking machines. He cuts all their pieces.
It's a real operation. Yeah, I mean, guys, they're making money.
And you don't have to cuddle afterwards.
Well, you go into one of them sex shops. I go into this one out by the truck stop, and you walk in there, and a few years ago, they had some dirty magazines, and they had like a couple of, you know, they had them things. And now you go in there, it looks like they got some fucking alien technology hanging on the walls there.
That's what I'm talking about. But it's all for the females, you know? It's like, you know, there's this rabbit pearl thing, and they've got all this stuff happen.
They talk about the
See,
heat.
The girls. What about my point? The women are being enslaved by the robots there.
They're going to get our women first.
I'm going to throw one of those things out.
They get the women.
No way.
Yeah,
we got the women getting enslaved by their vibrators. We got the children being enslaved in the schools. It's going to have to be us men folk that stand up and fight this robot threat.
Me big tough man.
Although, don't forget about our buddy up in Amish country there, Eric White, and his virtual sex machine. I mean, that's...
You couldn't pay me enough money to strap that thing to my dick. I'm sorry.
The virtual sex machine?
That thing was quite frightening.
I got one out in the touching shed.
I ain't touching yours, bitch.
It's not mine.
Of course not.
Perry used it. Remember on Unscrewed? Staff scientist Perry. Anyway, that was like 4 years ago. Anything's dead. It was probably there's a possum living nesting in that thing. I don't know, though. Yeah, I'm not sure. You know, we talk about, you know, it sounds, in many ways, it sounds like an appealing thing. So you get a robot.
They say the rolling blackouts caused by the heat wave. I think it's because of women plugging them things in. It's like sucking the juice down. You drive down a quiet suburban street at night, you hear those things chugging along. It was like, everybody's using those things now. It's not. Well, fuck it. I mean,
that's right. Fuck it. I like where you're going with this. Continue.
Well, they need to make some of that shit for men.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what they're saying with these robots. They're going to be doing that within 5 years. I'm not sure how sexy these robots would be, though. Did you see that thing on Yahoo the other day? I was right on the front page of Yahoo about that new Chinese robot named Rong Cheng. What does that mean, Gator? Rong Cheng? You say you lived over there in China. You know, is that like a proper name, or is that an actual? Can we translate that?
I don't know what that means.
You know what? This might. I think it's Sichuan dialect, and you're a Mandarin guy. But anyway, Rong Cheng is dubbed the first Chinese, quote, beauty robot.
Yes!
This lady robot, she's able to respond to some 1,000 Chinese words. That's all you really need, you know, if you think about it.
All you need is no, yes, harder, faster, slower.
Oh, Joey, that's awful. Well, she can dance, she can bow, she can, that's good. She can greet people in the Sichuan dialect.
You say Xiaojie.
And she's destined for the Sichuan Science Museum to serve as a receptionist. The robot costs about $37,500 to make. But check out the picture of her there. What do you think about that?
She's hot, man. I think
you think that's hot? I don't know about the term beauty robot. Thing looks like Haley Joel Osment in AI. You really want to?
He's got two hands and a skirt. I'm in.
Haley Joel Osment.
That's what it looks like, man.
I think he's a robot. You say, Xiaojie, well, yeah, I need Pung Wo to Xiao Didi.
Maybe if they, Xiao Didi, that means little brother.
It means, it does. Xiao Didi means little brother.
That's a euphemism for one's penis, little brother.
I look at that robot and say, Xiaojie, well, Yi Jian Zhong Xin. It means the first time I saw you, I fell in love.
Well, maybe if she put a wig on or something. Look at her. I mean, as it stands, it looks like one of the mannequins I used to rub up against in Macy's when my mom took me there as a boy. And then, you know, you go
high. There's something goddamn sexy about mannequins.
You know those mannequins? And you rub up against them, then you go hide in the middle of one of those circular clothing racks there. And you'd hide in there and just come what may. You know? You're a little kid. You don't know what's wrong.
I will cut this off right here. I don't want you talking too bad about Rong Cheng, because next time you see me, I'm going to be like, hey, Martin, I want you to meet Rong Cheng.
Everybody Rong Cheng tonight.
I just got scared. They put the teacher voice box in this thing, have that teaching our kids, and the kids get hot for teacher. This could be kind of scary. Be starting a whole thing of...
See, now this is the one going after the men. Mm-hmm. We got the children. We talked about that. We talked about how the women are being enslaved by the robot. Now we got Rong Cheng. Now we got Rong Cheng. Of course, it's Red Chinese coming after us. Now they're going to enslave all of his menfolk with this, these beauty robots.
Yeah, that's what they're going to do.
You know?
Well, who do you think's behind all this? Who's making these robots?
Cheney. Cheney and the Cheney bots.
Dick Cheney.
It's a theory. I don't know.
I don't know either.
You know.
I think it's a Korean.
We found another good question.
We have. We want your answers. Send us your answers. ProbeMartin@gmail.com.
No, I think what we should do is have everybody draw the picture of the best robot that they'd like to have sex with. Yes. If they could make a robot.
Is that what we want to do for
us? That's our drawing challenge.
That's going to be some real... Should it be the one that they want to have sex with most?
Well, say they do make a robot that men can have sex with.
Uh-huh.
I say they make that. Like, somebody can make that. I want the ideal prototype of everybody's ideal... sex robot. Now, if you're going to make a sex robot, now this could be the sky's the limit here, man, because it's a robot. Like, you can make it interchangeable, faces interchangeable, whatever you want to do, you know.
This is your fantasy come to life, basically. This is your...
I've been waiting for this fucking day for a long time, man. I'm thinking of getting one of them Rong Cheng dolls and be like, hey... But I just don't want it to look
like...
You're
going to get these submissions. You're going to run out of Home Depot, buy yourself a welding rig, and go to work.
I'm going to take it to my butter. I'm going to take it to my buddy, Stevie. I'll be like, here, man, make this. You got to send in the blueprints. That's the new drawing challenge. And Gator's going, I'm going to make a life size of it.
That's your challenge, Infected Army. Send in your picture of the robot that you'd like to fuck.
And don't make that fucker look like Haley Joel Osment either.
Anyway, that's all the time we got for this special Infected Robots edition.
Martin, tell a story.
Yeah, you know, Gator, you know...
Story! Yes!
Martin, tell me a motherfucking story or lose me forever!
We really don't have time, but seeing as how this is the special robot edition, I guess it's okay.
Yes!
This is the story of Frankie 7, the friendliest robot. Once upon a time, there was a little robot named Frankie 7. He was the friendliest robot. At the meatpacking plant, where he stuffed pork bits into aluminum cans for poor people to buy, he always whistled from his little gears that they spun around. So happy he was to be a robot. But sometimes, when one of the human workers at the pork cannery would punch out for the day, Frankie 7 couldn't help but feel a little sad, because he wanted to leave the hot, smelly plant too, and explore the big world outside he'd heard some of his transportation robot friends talk about.
Oh, said Frankie 7, I'm happy here, stuffing all these pork bits into cans for people on food stamps to buy, but I know there's more to life, and I want to taste it. I'll bet if I could leave the plant, I could use my precision movements and deceptively strong pincer-like pinchers to help people more than I do canning pork. If somebody would just give me the chance.
Then one day, a contractor from Microsoft came to the plant to install a new ROM chip into some of the robots, expanding their capabilities. And the ROM chip that was to be installed into Frankie 7 was to give him mobility so he could go with the transportation robots to stock shelves in the ghetto markets where the canned pork was sold.
Oh boy, said Frankie, this is my chance to get out there and help people.
But when the Microsoft technician installed the ROM chip into Frankie 7, it conflicted with his BIOS, causing a fatal error, frying all his circuitry. It'd be nice to think that Frankie 7 never knew what hit him as he became a worthless heap of wires and silicon. But anyone at the pork cannery that day will tell you, when the ROM chip was installed, awful sounds of crackling electricity and grinding metal could be heard, and black smoke seeped from his joints as he slowly burned from the inside out, taking about 4 excruciating minutes for him to completely shut down and become lifeless. For a robot, I can't imagine a more painful death. The end.
Did Frankie 7 have, like, was he a Down syndrome robot? And I'm just
poor little fuck.
No?
That's a start. I thought we had to get rid of these fucking robots.
Yeah.
Like, Frankie 7. Know, but I didn't know that it was him that stuffed them pork bits, because I used to eat those all the time.
You like that?
Yeah.
They're so delicious.
I lived off those for about a year and a half between 1986 and 1987.
You know, you smear them on bagel chips. You ever try that?
On what?
Bagel chips. Bagel chips. That's how I say it. From
I don't eat that.
You don't eat that fancy.
I put it on some white bread, and I used to pack a lunch with that pork, them pork chips. Whew. I tell you what.
Well, that's really all the time we have for this special Robots edition of Infected. For Joey and the Gator, this is Martin Sargent reminding you, don't get ripped by the Riptide.
I am a musical robot. Let's all dance.
We'll see you at the bar.
This has been Infected. If you are still listening, you are infected. If you are infected, then God have mercy on your human soul. Because if you are still listening, you are a depraved, scummy, fucking, worthless piece of human trash, and we will be all that much easier when we come to take the world from you, you sucker. I will sucker punch you in your fat white stomach and make you double over in pain, because this is Infected, and we are signing off now.
Oh yes, round 10, yes. Oh, round 10, give it up.
Joey.
I'm gonna have to sell that fucker now.
Anybody want to buy a robot?